All right, everybody. Thanks for hopping on this call. I appreciate your time. I know we're all busy, but we want to try and figure out if it's even feasible to run a virtual night of reflections for the class of 2020. Please let me know your thoughts.
Well, my thoughts are, why am I here? I've been on sabbatical since January, and I feel like, you know, what's the... Hey, get off the shed! Listen, I got to go. I got to teach Ebenezer and Ichabod.
All right. Does anyone else want to leave before we move forward?
Where were we?
Yeah, buddy, I'll be done in a minute. I got to help plan this virtual NOR thingamajig. I don't know. Yeah, that was Dr. Best. He's the administrator, shaves his head like me to try and, you know, look this good. I think Mr. he can grow a mustache, though.
Mr. Tomlinson.
What? Yeah, Starbucks. Always Starbucks with him. I bet he's wearing, like, basketball shorts with that suit.
All right. Mr. Mulford, what are you doing?
Can you guys see me?
Mr. Mulford, move away from the camera.
Okay. Mr. Hagen, where's Mr. Hagen? Isn't he the senior class co-advisor?
Yeah, but he doesn't really do anything. I mean, I can invite him so he feels important.
All right, guys, so speaking of important, our time is important, so let's get ourselves back on track here. To recap, we've run Night of Reflections for 10 years. We want to send off the class of 2020 as well as possible. Can we do this?
Can we do a virtual NOR? I mean, yeah, why not? I mean, we can compete with Netflix and TikTok and Snapchat. I mean, I, for one, have spoken at Night of Reflections before, and I'd love to come in and speak in front of an empty auditorium and sing Miley to no one. And another thing.
All right. That was not productive. Does anyone have anything of value to add to this conversation?
Yes!
McCaff, what do you got?
Oh, sorry. I was just watching the replay of the Super Bowl. Again, Philly. You know, it never gets old. Every time I watch it, we win.
McCaffrey, I couldn't agree with you more. However, that couldn't have less to do with our conversation than it does. Does anyone have anything to add? Miss Banshee, you got anything?
Oh, you know, I mean, you know, it's going to be no problem. We've got 400 kids in 400 different spaces, and they left midway through the year. So we've got, you know, trying to collaborate and get all those memories together, and they deserve a really great ending. So, you know, no pressure.
Banshee, I thank you for summarizing what we all already know and helping us to admire the problem. Is there anything we can actually do for this group? Do we have any ideas?
All right, well, let's face it. Everybody has been getting used to video and relying on it during this time. And there's a lot of power in film and in storytelling. So my BWTV crew has been busy making videos all year. I'm sure I can get some of them together and we can make some videos to tell the story of the students' time here at Tennant.
I absolutely love that idea. You know what? Night of Reflections is more than a night just in an auditorium. It's a night for inspiration, words of wisdom. And this faculty misses the class of 2020. They want to say goodbye. I'm going to go make it my mission and go wrangle up some of the faculty. Woo!
These guys are champions. They dominated Powder Puff 2 years in a row. They deserve a champion send-off. Let me see what I can do.
All right, guys. Well, I appreciate the enthusiasm. I really want a great night of reflections. Is there anything else I can do to support you?
No, thank you so much, Dr. Best. We appreciate all of your support.
All right. Well, you have my support, and don't disappoint me.
What do you think?
I think you know what to do.
Oh, hello. Well, this isn't how any of us thought that we'd be holding Night of Reflections. You know, it's funny because every year we have it, people ask me, what's your favorite Night of Reflections that's ever been held? And to be honest, every year my answer is there is none, because it always reflects the class. And this reflects you. This reflects your night, and we shouldn't be here.
We should be here, and you should be there, and we should be surrounded by your family and friends, some of whom you've known for 13 years now. but we're not. And that's okay, because we're still a family. I want to let you know that tonight, everything that was filmed with the CDC guidelines and proper precautions taken. And tonight, you're going to hear from your classmates, faculty, and administrators. And the faculty that you're going to hear from, you voted for. And what they're going to share with you tonight is times that they faced adversity and how they overcame it. Because let's face it, right now, many of us are feeling a lot of adversity. And we have in the past, and we probably will in the future. But it doesn't matter the adversity that you face, but rather what you choose to do with it. So tonight, sit back, smile, and enjoy. We're here to celebrate your time in our district and celebrate the many wonderful memories that you've had. Enjoy.
Good evening, parents, family, friends, administrators, board of school directors, and most importantly, the class of 2020. On behalf of the staff of William Tennant High School, I'd like to formally welcome all of you to our 2020 virtual Night of Reflection ceremony. Before we begin, I'd like to thank a few people that have made this evening possible. Ms. Hope Banshee, Ms. Dina McCaffrey, Mr. Ed Hagen, Mr. Nate Ross, our student presenters, and our faculty presenters. Let's give them all a round of applause from wherever you're watching this right now. Our goal for this evening's program is to touch the hearts and the minds of the class of 2020 and their families. Tonight's event will be filled with moving tributes, performances, and moments. Tonight we will laugh, tonight we will reflect, and tonight pretty much every one of you watching will cry at some point. Most of all, tonight will serve as a fitting tribute to the class of 2020, not only their time here at William Tennant High School, but their time throughout the Centennial School District. I hope you all enjoy this evening's program.
Good evening, everyone. I hope you and your family are staying safe in these challenging times. To our seniors, what an honor it is to be here for Night of Reflections. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to speak. So William Tennant does so many fabulous events, but to me, Night of Reflections is always my favorite. It's just a great way to connect with so many great kids. And I hope my words resonate with you tonight, because I really do think they are meaningful. So about 23 years ago, my father passed away from cancer. And 10 years prior to that, my mother passed away from heart disease. So being an only child, there was a huge amount of adversity that I had to deal with, you know, not having any siblings, and sure that I had friends, but it was incredibly challenging. And I kind of related to the things you're going through with the adversity you're dealing with. So before my father passed away, he was a Atlantic City buff. He loved to go down the shore, and I had just gotten married, and my wife and I decided to take him down. So it was the middle of April, and it was like a hurricane on the boardwalk. And we were walking on the boardwalk, and he was extremely frail because he was sick. And I said, "Hey, Dad, you know, do you want to go?" He was like, "No, Craig, I'm so appreciative of you and Kyle taking me down here. I want to take you out to lunch." So we went to his favorite restaurant down the shore. And as we were there, it kind of made me think about things like my father's walking around with cancer. And instead of focusing on that, he was really focusing on just happiness of being with his family. And even though there was a large amount of adversity, he was so optimistic and positive. And even today, I still remember that. And I hope I can relate it to all the things that are going on right now. So we've been at home for a couple months, and it has been challenging. You know, I have a daughter who's home from college and a son who's home. And it's crazy because we never go for walks. You know, a couple nights ago, the four of us went for a walk around our neighborhood, which we would never do. And again, even during these incredibly challenging times, we had a chance to do something together as a family. And that is one of the key things I want to mention to you. Yes, you're home, and it's hard. It's challenging to be there because you want to be doing other things. Gosh, even for me, people will say, hey, Shap, you know, it must be great being home. No, it's not. I'd rather be at school with colleagues that I care about and students. So it is challenging, but there is always a bright side through this adversity. You get a chance to spend time with your family that you might not normally do. Just sitting there eating dinner. Yeah, you're listening to your parents. Put your phone away. Yep. I say that to my kids. And playing like 5,000 rounds of Monopoly or Life or whatever board game you play. I mean, I know we're playing games and I can't draw, so it's totally pointless. But it's the time with our families that really do matter. You know, that is what makes this special. And even your friends, look, I realize that you might not see them, but virtually through any social media, you're spending time with them. So there's a couple things that I really want to leave you with. Three things that to me matter so much. During adversity, and even without it, be positive. Positivity helps us to deal with so many challenges in life. Along with that positivity is a certain amount of optimism that we should always have no matter what, especially during challenging times. And number three, again, your family and friends matter. They matter a lot and they will always matter. I lost both of my parents and I will never ever forget when my father died, I was sitting upstairs in my room crying. One of my friends came up. His name was Rich. He came up and gave me a hug, and it was, I'll just never forget it. The power of family and friends is everything, especially during these times. So seniors, I miss you. I say that sincerely. I miss seeing you every day. I miss your smiles and your hope and your enthusiasm. I hope that when things get better, you will come visit. I mean that matters, whether it's in person or virtually. Send an email, say hello, because these times will end they will get back to normal, but being positive, optimistic, and spending time with others matters. Thank you so much for being here tonight. I love you guys.
Hello, I'm Valerie, and I am doing a poem entitled Jackets. My jacket is a safe haven, full of comfort and reliability and opportunity, weaving together many different fabrics, all with their own characteristics. Pockets for storage of everyday necessities, along with those of utmost value. School is my jacket, wearable at a variety of events, football games, band practice, after-school clubs. A fabric that shows our true colors of black and white. Our jackets have been on many journeys with us. We carry them everywhere, traveling from grade to grade, from kindergarten to senior year, and even into our future. They have been our protection from the outside world. Scary and uncertain times are hard, but our jackets allowed us to show others who we were. Jackets shared with dearest friends, which made it a sanctuary. Everyone's jacket is different. They have no size and no sense of judgment, only the optimistic outlook on what it represents. The way we have worn them through the halls of Tenet varies for us all, and our jackets over time have changed, but the pockets continue to fill.
The visual arts play a significant role in the culture of William Tennant High School's academic experience. The most memorable of these experiences traditionally culminates in the senior showcase exhibition of senior walls at Showcase Night each spring. Unfortunately, that tradition was not possible this year. Tonight, the teachers of the art department would like to congratulate all graduating seniors who've spent time learning in our classes, creating artwork and memories, connecting with one another, and making their mark in our school. We celebrate the senior artists who've made a significant commitment to their arts education and have chosen to participate in our virtual showcase. We celebrate your achievements and look forward to the mark you'll make in the world.
Good evening. Please open your test booklets to page 2. Do not begin until I have finished reading all of the directions. When choosing an answer, please make sure to fill in the circle completely and do not make any stray marks in the answer booklet. If you need to change an answer, make sure to erase it completely. Keep working until you see the stop sign. This will indicate that you are finished working in this section. We've all heard these words before, and don't worry, you don't have a test. This is Night of Reflections, and that's the last thing that we want to reflect on. But it was at this moment, while reading test directions, that a teacher felt a very strange wave come over him. The sound in the room drowned out, the walls felt like they were closing in, and there was a feeling of being detached from reality, almost as if he was about to leave this world. His heart began racing as the fear of fainting, even dying, swept over him. He bolted out of the classroom and asked another teacher to take over. He walked as fast as he could to the nurse, and she could tell something was wrong as soon as he walked in. Over the next few weeks, he underwent a series of tests to check his heart and nervous system. Thankfully, the test showed there were no serious underlying health conditions, but this mystery remained. Why did that happen? And why was it still happening? I finally got the answers to these questions when my doctor diagnosed me with panic disorder. Panic disorder? You're kidding me, I said. I don't panic about things. I'm rock solid. Kinda. This is something that only happens to other people, I thought. And people with anxiety just need to tough it out because it's just in their head. But after learning more about it, and unfortunately having more of these experiences, I turned my attention to accepting it for what it is and learning how I can continue to live my life the way I want to. As the greatest maintenance man and karate teacher of all time, Mr. Miyagi, once said, "It's okay to lose to your opponent. You must not lose to fear. Never be afraid to be who you are. Don't let any challenge or illness, injury, or even any other person define who you are. Only your actions can do that. So make them count." I'm now at a place where I have things under control, at least I feel like I do, but getting to this point wasn't easy and it didn't happen overnight. I struggled with the stigma of anxiety and how I foolishly thought it made me less of a person. I couldn't understand why this had to happen to me all of a sudden at age 36. I wondered if I could even do my job as a teacher anymore, or do the little everyday things like drive a car. Would I have to live with the fear of these random, terrifying episodes lurking over my shoulder for the rest of my life? Finally, I made the decision that I wasn't going to let this control me. Overcoming challenges or learning how to deal with them looks different for everyone, but it is possible when you decide to commit to it and seek help from your family and friends. At the time this happened, I thought I had it all figured out, that I was well over the hump in terms of growing up and getting over the stresses of adulthood. Now I'm actually getting closer to being over the hill, but I learned that challenges can hit you at any time and usually when you least expect them. You might not be prepared, but you can always persevere. Never give up in the face of a challenge. There is always something you can do, and there is always somebody depending on you. If not now, then in the future. And you should do it for you, because you are important. You do matter. Ups and downs will happen in life, so get ready. But always remember to revel in the greatness of life and not wallow in its hardships. I'm going to close with a paragraph from an open letter I wrote to seniors when this thing first happened. Remember, it's not plagiarism if you quote yourself. Or maybe it is. You can ask Miss Banshee that. Or better yet, Mr. Francis. Perhaps we can get his cell number scrolling at the bottom of the screen. He would enjoy the phone calls from you. I believe that every challenge and moment of adversity provides an opportunity to grow. And this current challenge, as enormous as it is no different. I'm sorry this happened, but I'm also confident that you will come out of it stronger and more determined than ever. You didn't ask for this, and you don't deserve it, but you will own it, adapt to it, and overcome it. One positive we can take away from this is that we're all learning again, perhaps the most important lesson of all. The time with friends, family, and loved ones is precious, and we should never take it for granted. Let this be the enduring message of the class of 2020. Thank you all for the memories. I will cherish them and I will miss you. My best wishes to you always as you embark on the next chapter, and congratulations on all that you've accomplished.
It seems like yesterday we started school so small, kindergarten was the start of it all. We met our teachers, rode the bus, and made new friends too. Learning our ABCs was just one thing we learned to do.
In first grade, we learned how to read and write. Our decorated classrooms were oh so bright. Lunch and recess were the best part of our days, and the Phillies won the World Series beating the Rays.
In second grade, our teachers gave us minute math drills. Learning how to write cursive was one of our new skills. In science, we experimented with a butterfly kit. After school, we watched Hannah Montana or SpongeBob for a bit.
Switching schools was a big change for some of us in third grade. The violin was an instrument that some kids played. This year also meant the start of the PSSAs. Oh, how can we forget those glorious days?
In fourth grade, we learned fractions in math class. Students could now play woodwind, percussion, or brass. Context clues and reading were important to find, but trading silly bands was always on our mind.
Hurricane Sandy was the big news this year. At fifth grade graduation, we all shed a tear. This meant recess and holiday parties were done. The Spirit of Philadelphia trip sure was fun.
In sixth grade, we were all fish in a big new pond. On Team A or Team B, we found new friends to bond. Tutorial filled hallways with music and song, and reinforce the things we have been learning all along.
In seventh grade, there were no longer teams. Field day co-captains was one of our dreams. Collecting ducks was all we thought about. For sports teams, we could finally try out.
In eighth grade, Singer Log games were a big deal, of course. On the Dorney Park trip, we went on rides like Steel Force. Our end of the year dance was something we all look forward to. After the eighth grade breakfast, it was time for something new.
We switched our colors from black and red to black and white. New school and locker troubles. Will we get anything right? Ninth grade was the time to join new clubs and meet a friend. Spring sports, 9-10 dance, and Ben Keystone's. Year one came to an end.
10th grade came and we were no longer the new kids on the block. We learned our schedule was changing, which was quite a shock. The Eagles went to Minnesota and won the Super Bowl. Time for PSATs, but learning to drive was our goal.
In 11th grade, our schedule was not the same. Sorry, seniors, we won the Powder Puff football game. SATs and AP classes caused a lot of stress. The power came on so we could wear tux or prom dress.
After all this time, senior year was finally here. Applying to college means the end of high school is near. Study hall was the perfect start or end to our day. For homecoming, Miss Panther and Mr. Tennant, we had the say. Winning Powder Puff 2 years in a row was the best. Our black and white night was better than all the rest. The school year ended abruptly due to Corona. Now it's time for the senior class to receive our diplomas.
Yes to my future, yes to my yesterday, yes to change, oh yes to my yesterday, no tomorrow without a yesterday, yes to my future, goodbye to yesterday. All these years I've been searching for who I'm supposed to be. All that time I've been wasting, 'cause I was right in front of me. Oh, it's a crooked old tradition. I must have found a magician. But in all this trouble I've had, I haven't got one single regret, no. Here's to my future, here's to my to change, oh, here's to my yesterday, not tomorrow without a yesterday, here's to my future, goodbye to yesterday, yesterday. Oh, I'm a hopeless crash collision, 'cause I'm a hostage to my pride. By my own volition, I've been a saint, I've been the truth, I've been the lie. Oh, it's a crooked old tradition. Regret, no. Here's to my future, here's to my yesterday, here's to change, oh, here's to my yesterday, not tomorrow without a yesterday, here's to my future, goodbye to yesterday. Day, you can go, you can do anything you wanna. It's your play, swing low, go high anywhere you wanna. You can reach for the moon, anywhere your dreams could take you. Go astray, fade away, just leave it to yesterday. Here's to my future, here's to my yesterday. Here's to change, oh, here's to my yesterday. Not tomorrow.
Class of 2020, thanks for the invitation to be part of this special event. I'm honored to be a part of it, and I've missed you. Let me start with the obvious. Storms come. We can try to avoid them, but they continue to roll in. And these storms come in varying degrees. Some are quick, others linger on far too long. Some are mere nuisances, others life-altering. Some are deeply personal and private, while others are battled in public. Some we see coming, others are not in the forecast and approach without warning. Some involve relationships, others rage within our own minds. Some are commonly experienced and understood, others more rare and tragic. Storms come. So when the winds begin to blow us off course and the waves begin to rock the boat, when the path out is unclear or lost, when we can't reach a safe harbor on our own, what do we do? Sometimes we need to navigate through the storms we face. However, it is so very easy to lose our bearings and direction. We can quickly become turned around and lose our way. Navigation systems fail, and we are blinded by the circumstances we face. And in those times, we must not focus on the storm we are experiencing, but rely on the time-tested, storm-weathered reference points to orient our ship in the right direction. All too often, when faced with uncertainty or adversity, we focus on the tall waves and the high winds, the very things that disorient us and blow us off course. When in the midst of a storm, let's commit ourselves to fixing our eyes on a steadfast, unwavering reference point. Trust its position and stay the course. There will be times when life seems to be rolling along fairly smoothly, uneventfully, but suddenly the seas grow rough and unforeseen problems show up. The stability of the boat will be rocked, and we'll begin to flirt with the thought of abandoning hope. In those times, we must avoid throwing our hands in the air, shrugging our shoulders, and giving up. We must not allow our lives to drift, but rather place our faith in that which was created for the sole purpose of keeping the ship from drifting away, its anchor. Even the largest and strongest ships have them. And in those storms, when we can't navigate the ship, anchor deep and hold on tight. But be mindful. It is always wise to ask ourselves, in what or whom are we anchored? There is a real temptation to anchor ourselves to that which does more harm than good. Let's not anchor ourselves to shakable things, but to the immovable that will hold us steady until the storm passes. Yet there will be other times when we will grow tired and weary of the storm. The way out will seem too far and too impossible to reach. We'll grow impatient with waiting for it to be over. We will simply not have the strength or ability to maneuver through the narrow points and unfamiliar waters into a safe harbor alone. In those moments, it may be the wisest choice to be at peace with securing ourselves to another vessel that has traveled these waters before and can safely pull us to safety. And after being led out from a tumultuous time, we learn the navigable path. Not only will there be times of struggle when we will need to lean on someone to get us through, but there will be many, many opportunities for each of us to use our past storm experiences to help guide others through their current ones. Storms will come. Class of 2020, it is my prayer that you will not abandon all hope when the inevitable storms of life occur. May you have the wisdom to discern when you must navigate by keeping your eyes fixed on an immovable reference point. Steady the ship by anchoring deep into something solid, or hold firmly to another and trust them to pull you into that safe harbor. Congratulations. Thank you. God bless.
Each year, the yearbook staff dedicates the yearbook to a tenant staff member who makes a difference in the Centennial community.
This year's yearbook is dedicated to one of the most caring people at Tenet, who goes above and beyond every day to make our school a better place.
Whether you know her personally or just passing in the halls, she always goes out of her way to make sure everyone feels comfortable and safe.
We are honored to present this year's yearbook to Dr. Henrik. Thank you for everything that you do for our students, school, and our Centennial community.
Class 2020, for the past 4 years, we've called this school our home. As freshmen, we came in unknowing, nervous, and uncertain. As sophomores, we had a stronger footing, but graduation was still too far away to even seem possible. Junior year, we learned from our seniors and waited to take their place. And now, here we are at the end of our four-year journey. We are the leaders and role models of this school, and tomorrow we will take the next step. Some of us will become freshmen all over again. Others will go into the infamous real world. We will leave behind the certainty that we had. But even though we are departing, no one can deny us our legacy. We have shaped this school and impacted how it stands today. This is our legacy. This is our hope. And now, as we look to the future, it's time to pass the torch. The juniors are the future of our school. We hope we've left this place better than we found it. And we hope that you continue to build on the tradition that gave us so many memories. Take this legacy we gave to you and honor it. We wish you a successful senior year filled with indelible memories that will change, shape, and mold you into women and men ready to take on whatever obstacles may come your way. This is your legacy now. Please welcome the class of 2021.
Hey everybody, I hope you're staying healthy and I hope you're staying well. I really miss all you guys. I miss going to school. I miss seeing my friends. So here's a little song that we all remember from our childhood that really accurately represents friendship. Thank you.
Good evening. Before I begin tonight, I want to take a moment to thank those who made this event possible. Ms. Banshee, Mr. Hagan, Ms. McCaffrey, the administration at William Tennant High School, and our technology department, you always put a tremendous amount of work into Night of Reflections. This year has been uniquely challenging, and I am so thankful you were able to make this tradition happen. Most importantly, to the seniors of the class of 2020, thank you for giving me the opportunity for speaking this year. It truly means so much. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Mrs. Hsu, and I teach social studies. Tonight, I would like to briefly talk about plans, and more specifically, what happens when those plans change. My students can probably attest to the fact that I'm the type of person who loves a good plan. I give my classes a calendar of assignments a month in advance. I leave myself lists all over my desk of things I have to do, and I've been told once or twice that allegedly I can be a little uptight. I'm not sure I entirely believe that rumor, though. The truth is, no matter how much we try and control our world, things don't always go as we had hoped. I remember being about your age when I faced a detour in my plans. Like most of you, I spent the better part of my junior and senior year of high school figuring out my future. I visited colleges, I went on tours, and by the end of my senior year, I thought I was set. I picked the perfect school, and my to-do list was totally checked off. But that next fall, my plan didn't work out like I thought it would. I went to school, and after a few months, I realized something. I hated it. For the first time in my life, my plan and my reality didn't match up, and if I'm being honest, I felt a little lost. But here's what that year taught me. Sometimes our plans take a detour, or get modified, or get thrown out altogether, and that is all okay. It's from those moments of change that we change. We learn about ourselves, we clarify what's important in our life, and we grow. Ironically, in early March of this year, my psychology students and I were starting a unit on stress. Sometimes the universe really does have great comedic timing. To start off the unit, I had my students answer the following question: what stresses you out? Some of the student responses were really serious. You shared your worries about caring for loved ones who were sick, or your fears about finding a way to pay for college. Some of you were honest about school frustrations, like all the classes and how to juggle them, or the fact that the R and the T keys had stopped working on your Chromebooks. My favorite responses were the unique answers that were brutally honest, like those of you who shared things, like the things that stresses you out most in the world is the sound of other people chewing. The reality is, though, whatever stresses you out, sometimes that stress can be a real barrier. As you think back over your high school experience, you can all recall times that you faced a detour. Maybe you didn't do as well in a class as you had hoped you would. Maybe you got cut from a team. Or maybe you had a relationship that really mattered to you and fell apart. Those times were likely hard, but they also taught you something along the way. Whatever your unique story is, it's important to remember that we all face difficult times. But as humans, we have the remarkable ability to adapt. In reaching this endpoint of your high school career, realize that you have gone through countless challenges, and whether they were big or small, you have overcome them all. You should be so proud of this accomplishment, and we are so proud of you. As you start the next chapter of your story, it's important to recognize that detours will happen. Remember to pay attention to how they can change you for the better. One of the things that has impressed me the most over these past 2 months is how you all have been growing and changing for the better during this current detour. You have shared stories with your teachers of how you're balancing schoolwork with working long hours in food stores or retirement communities. Some of you have used this time to reconnect with family and friends. Others have reignited their love for art or music, and an abnormal number of you have shared the fact that you've taken up playing the ukulele. I am blown away by the ways you have handled this detour. You have positive attitudes, you make the best of difficult situations, and you always inspire me. Again, I can't thank you enough for how much this honor means to me. Thank you for choosing me to speak to you tonight. I am so proud of you for graduating high school. Congratulations, your future is so bright, and I can't wait to see all the ways you continue to grow and shine. Thank you.
Dear class of 2020, I've always told myself everything happens for a reason. From coming into this world when the country was recovering from 9/11 to losing our graduation to a pandemic, we were born to grow amidst the chaos. We came into senior year counting down the days until we could throw our caps into the air and scream, "We did it." But the sweet rewards for all of our hard work are gone just like that. Instead of looking at this negatively, we have to remember all of the positives of our past year. Senior year began with homecoming, the second week of school, where we danced the night away with our homecoming king and queen. A month later, the football team won their first home game in years, and I don't think I've ever screamed so loud at a sports event. For a second year in a row, we ran onto the field as winners and held the Potter Cup trophy in the air. The first ever Miss Panther took place, and I was lucky enough to be nominated as a candidate. It was one crazy adventure, and along the way, I've made some of my closest friends. While we spent all year solidifying our friendships, those friendships only grew stronger when Black and White started. From dancing on the stage at Academic Night, to racing across the pool in a canoe, to pulling the rope so far you have to open the side doors during tug of war, Black and White was nothing short of a memorable experience. If I've learned anything from this past year, it's to appreciate the little things. Cheering in the football stands alongside your friends, Mr. T asking where your hall pass was, watching BWTV when there's no glitches, even just getting to walk with your friends in the hallway between classes. We all have a lot to be thankful for, especially those teachers and friends who have helped make you into who you are today. The mess-ups, the laughs, and the lessons are memories that we will carry with us forever. Although we will never be able to step foot in Tenet as students again, and we won't get to step on stage for graduation, I know we will be stepping into our futures with one hell of a story to tell.
That's all for us today.
Hello, I'm Dominic Chalot.
And I'm Alex Kemp.
And we have the honor of presenting this year's Senior Recognition Award to a teacher that means a lot to the both of us. I had this teacher for 2 years during my high school experience. This person always motivates me to do my best and to keep my priorities in check. He has taught me to never give up when facing adversity, as well as never quitting on anything that comes my way. The best trait this teacher has, in my opinion, which even makes me laugh, is his precise schedule planning over the course of the year. This is a person of determination to make sure his students do the very best on any task and to make sure they are prepared for anything that comes their way. I will always remember his advice and personality and hope to one day be able to perform in my profession the same way and to be able to pass the same life-changing advice to others. This person will always be remembered.
I've only known this teacher for a short amount of time, but during that time, this teacher made a huge impact on me. He is thoughtful to each and every one of his students. He is as strict as he is funny and enthusiastic about his job. During this time I got to spend with this teacher, he made me a more perceptive and open-minded to new ideas.
It is our pleasure to present this year's Senior Recognition Award to Mr. Paul Veltri.
Thank you for all of you done for the class of 2020.
Hi everybody, I'm Sophia Trazzi, if you didn't know me already. I'm really excited and grateful to be part of Night of Reflections and to be able to celebrate graduating high school with all of you. Tonight, I'm going to be singing Smile by Nat King Cole, and I chose this song because, as you know, our country is facing hard times, and the song has a great message of staying positive, which I hope we can continue to apply to our lives as we move forward. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile. If you just smile. If you just. Oh.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Victoria Farrow, or as most of you know me, Tori. I'm a member of the class of 2020, and I'll be presenting the senior speech. When I was a freshman, my neighbor who was a senior drove me in every day, before the speed bumps were put in. Towards the end of the school year, she said her night of reflections was coming up. I asked her what that was, and she responded with, basically a night where everyone cries. So, here goes nothing. This isn't the way we all pictured our senior year to end. We thought we would be sitting in class with the worst senioritis, dreaming about graduation. But if there is anything the class of 2020 is used to, it's change. We have participated in some incredible events over the past 12 years. When we were young students, many of us had to adapt when we moved into new elementary schools. Then again in middle school, when we had to work our way around a new schedule that didn't involve teams. Finally, in high school, you guessed it, our schedule was changed again. This time to block scheduling. But that's what makes the class of 2020 so strong, our willingness to keep going after things have changed. We all had so many memories in between the changes, from Longstreth to fire trucks that would come on field day. Leary kids may remember the big yellow slide from recess. Stackpole kids used to sing the telephone game. McDonald kids remember the recess aide Steve, who loved playing wall ball with them. Willowdale kids used to climb the big cheese during recess. Davis kids spelled the name of their school out of the student body. And of course, who can forget the rivalry between Log and Klinger? The 8th grade dance made us middle schoolers so nervous. It was our first serious school dance. None of us could forget how we scrambled to find dates as little 8th graders. And then came the big high school. We came into Tennant not knowing any teachers. Who knew so many of them would make such an impact on us? Government class this year consisted of Mr. Brown's hour-and-a-half-long talks about literally anything. I think we heard the story of his daughter getting her Social Security number stolen like 4 times, just so we could finally understand what the FTC was. During the holiday season, Mr. Freeze was on the announcements as Buddy the Elf. He played the part perfectly. Mrs. Reach never had to play a part. She was naturally so sweet and caring. If we ever needed someone to cheer us up, she's our go-to girl. We definitely didn't need a cheering up after winning Powder Puff for 2 years in a row. We proved to all those who said Powder Puff was rigged that they were wrong. And speaking of winning, Black did win 3 out of the 4 years at Tennant, just saying. But Black and White was an event full of happiness for everyone involved. We made some forever friendships over all the hard work. But in reality, from the moment we stepped into this school, we made history. Football won their first homecoming game in 4 years. Boys basketball, girls soccer, and field hockey made playoffs. Girls volleyball beat the defending champions. Track went to states. Boys swimming went to districts. Lacrosse became a sport. Marching band got to play in California. We get to have 3 dances plus a prom every year.
Well, maybe not prom this year.
Tenet has given us so many gifts and opportunities no other school has. We have come to love our staff and administration that make all of these events happen. And of course, we have come to love each other and the school we grew up in. We have all been there for each other, whether it was for something small, like a hard test, or something that affected the country, like a pandemic. We are all upset we aren't sitting in the auditorium now, looking over at one another. But we are strong. Nothing can stop the class of 2020, not even a pandemic. We were the class of change. Even though we were thrown obstacles, we overcame them and found success. I want to thank my classmates and teachers for everything they have done for us and for being there for us. Yes, we've been dealt with a lot of adjustments through our lives, but we rose above. And who says we can't continue that legacy for the rest of our lives? No one, because we are the class of 2020.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we gonna have. You don't need money, got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all. Bracelet. May you keep the chaos and the clutter off your desk. May you have unquestionable health and less stress. Having no possessions, though immeasurable wealth. May you get a gold star on your next test. May your educated guesses always be correct. And may you win prizes shining like diamonds. May you really own it each moment to the next. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all.
Your path is, if you believe it, then anything can happen. Go, 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 raise your glasses. Go, 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 you can have it all. I toast you. Here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have.
Gonna have. Here's to you always making me laugh.
Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all.
Hello, and thank you, administrative team, for putting on such an event here at William Tenet, such as Night of Reflections. Thank you to our senior advisors, Mr. Hagen and Ms. Banshee, for all the hard work they did to put this night together. And finally, thank you, class of 2020, for not only voting for me, but for attending William Tenet and giving me a job. Little round of applause. You know, it's very difficult to be here speaking tonight, for obvious reasons. I'm a man that's used to speaking in front of large audiences, pep rallies, black and white academic. And, you know, I'm just so used to living for the applause, applause, applause. But the virus kind of came in and hit us like a wrecking ball. And now we're lying on the cold, hard ground in trouble, trouble, trouble. For those of you scoring at home, that was Lady Gaga, Miley Cyrus, and Taylor Swift all rolled into one. You're welcome. I can hear the laughter from here. Ms. Banshee asked me to speak about adversity. And when I first thought of adversity, I thought, this is easy. I've had a lot of adversity in my life. I could speak about being a Philadelphia Eagles fan, but a couple years ago, they won the Super Bowl, and that's kind of been diminished. I could talk about the hardships of being a coach at William Tenet for the girls' volleyball team, but we've beaten every team in the Suburban One League, and this past year we beat the defending champions, Central Bucks West, 3-1 on our home court. I could talk about Miley not answering my emails or tweets, but we both kind of accepted it's a one-way relationship, and I'm okay with that. No, true adversity, when I thought about it, is something that hurts. It's something that changes the way you see things about life. And usually, if we look closely enough, it happens for a reason. It is important to never minimize what someone else considers a hardship. What might be silly to one person could be very real pain to another. In 1995, I was graduating right here from William Tenet, and I was going away to Bloomsburg. This was not the first time in my life that I had faced adversity, but it was going to be the most difficult. Not because I was leaving for college, but because I was leaving behind my girlfriend, the cutest, coolest girl I had ever met. She made me a better version of myself. I know, it's hard to believe. 18-year-old me being better, but it was true, it happened. I went off to Bloomsburg just 3 days after graduation to go to summer session and get ready for volleyball. We said our goodbyes and promised to write. Yes, actually write letters. There was not going to be any TikTok, Snapchat, Facebook, or Twitter. No texting. I had no phone, I had no car, and neither did she. We were stuck apart. After about the third letter, I knew we were both hurting and it was only going to get worse. We decided to end the relationship, and the pain I felt was something I knew I never wanted to feel again. That was it. No more relationships, never getting married, I was done. But some time passed, and hanging out with my friends and playing volleyball and going to class at college helped me through a really difficult time. I ended up a little over a year later having another relationship, having, you know, many after that, and eventually I even got married. Nobody ever wants to go through adversity, but we do. And it usually teaches us something and leads us to where we need to be. All my wrong turns and tough decisions, all the adversity I had to deal with in one way or another led me to the best relationship I could ever have asked for. On July 20th, 2017, I became a dad. And fast forward 3 years, to the present day, my wife and I are closer than ever to being able to adopt our beautiful 6-year-old son, Mason. He will always be my most important relationship on earth, and hopefully one that lasts a lifetime. So remember, look at the good in every bad situation. I didn't want that breakup back in 1995, but it helped shape who I am and helped build me for future relationships. Take care of one another and know we are always here for you at William Tennant. I will miss you, class of 2020. Stay your course, even if it gets rough, and enjoy your climb. I love you guys. Have a great night. If you ever need anything, you know where we are. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. My name is Julie Ryan, and I will be performing Secret for the Mad by Dodie Clark. I hope it gives you a sense of comfort in a very, very uncertain time and serves as a reminder that despite everything, you are still graduating. Congratulations, class of 2020.
I've got a secret for the mad. In a little bit of time, it won't hurt so bad. And I get it that I don't get it. But you will burn right now and then you won't regret it. You're not gonna believe a word I say. What's the point in just drowning another day? I get that I don't get it, but the world will show you that you won't regret it. Little things, all the stereotypes, they're gonna help you get through this one night. And there will be a day when you can say, okay, you mean it. I promise you. They're gonna help you get through this one night. And there will be a day when you can say, okay, I mean it. I promise you.
As our evening draws to an end, I'd like to take this moment to thank some people who helped make this night possible. First, our senior class advisor, Mr. Hagen, to Ms. McCaffrey for her countless hours spent editing and creating the videos, not just for tonight, but for the many other senior events that you've seen toward the end of this year. To Mr. Nate Ross for his expertise. To Ms. Collins and Ms. King for help taking the student-created artwork and making them a part of tonight. to our speakers for giving context to this evening, and to our administration, and in particular, Dr. Best, for their support, not just now, but throughout the year. We have two videos left for you this evening. One is a farewell from the students, and the other is a farewell from your faculty. But even though we're saying goodbye, always know we're here for you to lean on.
Go home early yesterday after a worker tested positive for the coronavirus.
We are hoping that we can move into phase two.
I think close to 14 million now. And so we have 14 million tests. And
we expect to see more cases across the United States.
As of 12 a.m. this morning, we have 610 new cases of COVID-19. This brings our statewide total to 63,666 Pennsylvanians.
Moving counties from red to yellow.
Members of the class of 2020 aren't getting to enjoy much.
There's just an enormous amount of uncertainty. Rituals matter in our society. You know, when you get to the end of one part of your life and go to another, that needs to be marked. Their life will go on, but they're right to feel a little bit cheated out of that.
This song is dedicated to you for defying the odds.
I'm gonna miss getting dressed up and going to all the dances with my friends.
I will definitely miss homecoming this year. Now, having the honor to be homecoming king has been like a life-changing experience.
Up and noticed he was nameless, he was homeless. She asked him his name and told him what hers was. He gave her a story about life with a glint in his eye and a corner of a smile. One conversation, a simple moment, the things that change us if we notice when we look up sometimes. They said I would never make it.
I'm going to miss Powder Puff.
The thing I'll miss most is probably Powder Puff. I loved running out onto the field with my friends after winning for the second year in a row.
To come young teachers, student doctors, sons on the front line, knowing they don't get to run. This goes up to the underdog. Keep on keeping at what you love. You'll find that someday, soon enough, you will rise up.
I'm gonna miss Powder Puff, Black and White, and seeing my dad every single day.
I'm gonna miss Black and White Night.
I'm gonna miss Black and White Night, especially White Dance and performing with all my friends and getting dressed up and all the practices. And I'm also gonna miss the poster meetings.
Speaking your mind. And she looked in his eyes in the mirror and he smiled. One conversation, a single moment, the things that change us if we notice when we look up sometimes. Listen, the only dream that I've been chasing is my own. So I sing a song for the hustlers trading at the bus stop, single mothers waiting on a check to come, young teachers, student doctors, sons on the front line knowing they don't get to run. This goes up to the underdog. Keep on keeping at what you love and you'll find that someday, soon enough, you will rise up.
I'm gonna miss William Tennant boys volleyball.
I'm gonna miss lacrosse.
What I'm gonna miss the most is playing on the tennis team, you know, going to all the practices and going all to the games and having fun.
I'm going to miss Tennant field hockey.
We'll miss spending every marching season with the Pit. Time has come for you to
leave. It's so hard to let you go. But in this life, I know you have to be.
I'm gonna miss BWT and seeing Miss McCaffrey.
What I'm gonna miss most about Tennant is seeing my friends every day.
I'm going to miss all the teachers that have helped me along the way.
I'm gonna miss seeing my friends and being in some of my favorite teachers' classes.
One thing that I'll miss about Tennant is the memories that I made.
I'll miss study halls with Miss Lutz.
What I'm gonna miss about Tennant is seeing all the staff and seeing all my friends in school.
I'm gonna miss my school mom, Mrs. King.
I'm gonna miss my friends making fun of my parking job every morning.
I'm going to miss seeing my friends, teachers, and Mr. T's fist bumps.
I'm going to miss seeing all my friends.
Some of the things I'm going to miss at Tenet is being able to see my friends every day and my favorite teachers. I'm also going to miss helping out and being a part of T Club.
I will miss the William Tenet Art Department.
I'm going to miss Tenet's art program.
One thing I'm going to miss about Tenet is being able to make music with my friends.
Hi everyone, I'm going to miss my friends, the musicals, Unified Track, and my teachers.
What I'll miss most about going to Tenet is getting to see my friends and have fun with them every single day, no matter what.
I'm going to miss laughing with my friends and seeing their faces every day. I'm also going to miss the music program.
My favorite memory of high school is participating in the musical all 4 years. Also, a big shout out to Miss Black, Miss Asia, and Dr. Katero for everything you made done for me. Begin, 'cause this is not goodbye. It's just I love you to take with you until you're...
Every day coming to school, you help to make my day better, and I'm truly appreciative of that.
Good luck with everything. Stay in touch, and I wish you all the best.
We are so proud of you. We miss you.
If you guys can improvise, adapt, and overcome here, then there's going to be nothing that's going to stop you.
The class of 2020 won't be defined by what you lost to this virus, but by how you responded to it.
No matter where you go and how you get there, don't forget where you came from.
Class of 2020, forever.
I know we'll meet again. Oh, this is not goodbye. I know we'll meet again. So let your life begin, 'cause this is not goodbye. It's just I love you to take with you.
Sometimes in our lives,
we all have pain.
We all have sorrow.
But if we are wise,
is we know that there's always,
always tomorrow.
Lean on me
when you're not strong.
And I'll be your friend.
I'll help you.
Carry on.
For it won't be long
till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Please swallow your pride.
If I have things that you need tomorrow.
For no one can fill.
No one can fill.
Those of your needs.
Those of your needs.
That you won't let show.
You just call on me, brother.
When you need a hand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
I just might have a problem that you'll understand.
We all need somebody
to lean on.
Lean on me. Lean on me.
When you're not strong.
And I'll be your friend.
I'll help you. Carry on.
For it won't be long.
Till I'm gonna need
somebody to lean on.
You just call on me, brother.
When you need a hand.
We all need somebody.
We all need somebody
to lean on.
I just might have a problem that you'd understand.
That you'd understand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
If there is a load you have to bear,
you have to bear.
That you can't carry.
That you can't carry.
I'm right up the road.
I'll share your load.
If you just call me, call me. If you need a friend.